Hello and greetings from Iceland, but this is just a short update since we had this rather large earthquake, magnitude 4.8 in Iceland's hotspot yesterday or in the ice-covered Bárðarbunga caldera in Vatnajökull glacier. And I know that many of you are curious about this, so to make it simple, we get the larger earthquakes or magnitude 3 plus almost every month, or around 11 of them for the last 12 months, and 9 the year before that. So we are still within the parameters of the abnormal norm we have here in Iceland. But an eruption is however imminent in Grímsvötn, according to our scientists, and there is a connection between those large volcanic systems, Bárðarbunga and Grímsvötn, so there is every reason to be on lookout around Grímsvötn, especially after those larger earthquakes in Bárðarbunga. But this time we can hardly see any aftershocks, so it's business as usual. But there is, however, land uplift in the Askja volcanic system, not so far away from Bárðarbunga, and there is also land uplift in Grímsvötn, so things remain a bit tense around there. But still, it's no reason to make a run for the hot dogs and wait for the barbecue to start. And let's take a detour now and follow the plate boundaries all the way up to North Iceland. But as I was finishing my last update, an earthquake struck just north from me, or just a few kilometers south from the main transform fault we should be worried about. It was just a quick snap this time, then nothing more, only a few aftershocks. But I do want to mention that the civil defense has this region in intensive care, since a magnitude 7 earthquake could strike there at any time. And every now and then we get rather strong seismic chapters, the last one in June 2020, and that time it was a north-south fault that was making a move. And one of our oldest experts said back then that we should not worry too much until the main Flatey Húsavík transform fault would move again, or just by the earthquake we had last week. And overall, this is a complicated seismic zone, and I'm not going to dive into that now. But what I can tell you from just looking at the seismic unrest at almost daily basis for the last years is that it would not surprise me if the next seismic chapter is close by. But if it will be the one that triggers the big earthquake, it is impossible to say, of course. And the people in Húsavík have been prepared for that reality, even a tsunami. And in addition to the earthquakes there, we see more earthquakes near the Krafla volcano in the recent months. The Krafla fissure swarm is 80 km long and around 4 to 10 km wide, with over 1,000 tectonic fractures. And it was during a tectonic chapter from 1975 to 1984 that we got the last large earthquake in North Iceland, or just around here. And during this episode, the Krafla volcano erupted 9 times. And since then, we have hardly seen any earthquakes around there, but there are few of them now, and I'm not going to call it an earthquake swarm, but clearly more activity than usual though. And I am mentioning this because Askja is shaking as well, and the seismic activity on the Tjornes fracture zone is also growing, and midst between them we have Krafla and Lake Mývatn. And by the lake we have a dormant but powerful system that erupted only 300 years ago and left us with this explosion crater. But it is not as I expect anything to happen there. I'm just telling you that the seismometers are turning on a whole lot of red lights along the complete North Iceland volcanic rift zone. And the Tjornes fracture zone is still pressing for the big one to go off. Or as I said in my New Year forecast, this year won't just tease us with volcanic activity. But I'm not going to make this longer today. We are indeed in more troubles when it comes to the weather these days. But it's more to come about that later, since it's an ongoing story. Could be better and could be worse. But this house in Hveragerði, the earthquake town by the South Iceland fracture zone, where I was flying around a few months ago, notice this white sports center there. It's an inflated balloon of some kind that actually withstood the Icelandic weather for 10 years or until yesterday. The house that is isolated with hot air got a hole in it during a storm and became the fastest sports center in the history of Iceland. And please let us know if you find it in your home country, because we want it back. But what can you say? There are different methods to cope with reality, and a dash of sarcasm has always worked for me. And we must be grateful for the fact that this weather chapter that has been plaguing us for the last days hasn't caused any fatal accidents. But this winter has, however, taken its toll. And I will cover that whole story when things get back to normal. But I want to remind you about my latest video about my old hometown Akureyri. It's a long one, since it's a special tribe up here in the north. So enjoy, and there will be more to come soon about my windy volcano island, Iceland.